Hello and welcome to another episode of Zuv Talks Photography. Today we're speaking about DSLR photography versus mobile phone photography. So we'll give you a few points of view and see how we feel about this, because I have a guest on today again and we're lucky to have Violet, who will be speaking to us briefly to explain some things that I've been thinking about for a while, because there's a lot of shooters out there that shoot on mobile phones. But what is the big difference in mobiles and DSLRs? So, Violet, hello, how are you?
Hi, Zulf. Very well, thanks. And you?
Yes, great for coming on. Thanks for sharing again, because it's always good to speak to you about your photography. I know you have your own channel, and I'll link to that so viewers can find you. We've had a few collaborations with Violet, and we've spoken about a few topics, but I thought it's good to cover something that we haven't covered before. So mobile phones and DSLRs are something many people transcend between. So if they were into photography from mobile phones, they've moved over to a DSLR and then carried on life. But what sort of limitations do you think are posed by DSLRs and mobile phones, for example?
Well, in the first place, I would say, you know, it's great to take photos and even video on mobile phones. You know, whether you have a Huawei or Samsung or iPhone, they're all equally good in terms of camera. Some people will argue the one is better than the other, but still, it takes a photo on a tiny little sensor. So it's all the same. Then you go to DSLR and you see, you know, the big difference when you pull these photos into a program like Premiere Pro or Lightroom or something, and you have to deliver a specific quality to a client, and there's just no match between cell phone photos and DSLR photos when it comes to delivering a product to a client. We have some clients where we take photos of their racing in the desert, and then, you know, you can't do that on a cell phone. The cars are moving fast, and you have to zoom further than what a cell phone can do. And also, when you deliver the final product to the client, they'll be printing those photos for the side of the trucks where the cars are being packed into and where the spares are being packed. And that truck is a 40-foot container that moves along the highway, and you can't print a digital photo from a phone in that size without a whole lot of pixelation.
Yes, definitely. I think you're right there. There's a lot of limitations that come into play, especially professionally. But what's happened is, I've noticed in the marketplace, mobile phone providers are starting to offer higher and higher megapixels. So I don't think higher megapixels help really, because as you mentioned, if the sensor is only tiny, all they're doing is give you more pixel counts, which are more smaller. So in theory, you're not actually getting a better shot at all. So I don't know how you feel about that.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I'm 100% with you on that. I mean, it's just, if you take any sort of picture and you blow it up, you do get a certain amount of pixelation. And then, you know, you get cameras that shoot in 50 megapixels right now, and that you can blow up to about a 10-meter billboard. But, you know, if you're going to work on something small, anything A4, A5, you know, up to maybe, I would say, a little poster, that would be fine on mobile photography. But as soon as you go bigger or larger than a meter by a meter, I wouldn't be printing the mobile photos on a meter by meter printout.
Yeah, definitely. I think that's a valid point, because a lot of people that use them will use them for like smaller prints. So then it's okay. It's for family, or you're taking shots which you would not have had otherwise. And if you didn't want to pick DSLR, for example, there's other mirrorless options as well, which are go between size. But like you mentioned, professionally and for shots that are more, well, for the money, basically, you need someone that you're paying a client for doing a shoot. You want to give them the best quality possible. So you're right, it's the place for DSLRs in that case. But yeah, that was really interesting quick chat we've had there about mobile phones and DSLRs. Thank you, Violet, for sharing your thoughts with us. It's interesting as always.
You're very welcome, and thanks for having me.
That's great. And we can touch on, you are from South Africa. Which part of South Africa are you from?
I'm actually right on the border between South Africa and Botswana in the Northwest province, where it's very, very hot and very, very dry.
Yes, I was thinking that. And like you mentioned with the zoom lenses, I'm sure they would come in their own, especially for wildlife and when you're out and about shooting. with a DSLR in that type of environment, obviously they're a bit more reliable than a mobile phone would be in terms of for longer term shooting.
Absolutely, and much more versatile. I mean, a 150 to 600 lens can do much more than a Huawei P30.
Yes, definitely. I think that's a great point to close on today and use this part of our creative collaborations. I've got a few more videos scattered on the screen that you can check out for further photography tips and tricks, and a link to Violet Henning's YouTube page, and she's also part of NaviPix Photography. So make sure to check her out and subscribe over to her channel. She's got some great content coming out, and I'll see you on the next video.